Welcome to episode 1 of Animal Workshop. I'm on the east coast of Tasmania at Rebbin Beach. Behind the beach lies the Sandspit Reserve. In front of the beach lies Mercury Passage and then Maria Island. I'm here to film the Hooted Dotteral, which presents certain difficulties which I hope to overcome. Filming the Hooded Dotteral presents quite a few challenges. Firstly, it's very difficult to get close enough to them, and second, if you're above them, you tend to film into the sand and they camouflage well with the sand. So my aim here is to film from a low position, but to do this, I need to build a device. I need to modify my camera. So if there's a problem, you can always build something to solve it. So it's into the workshop and turn the music up. So this is what I've built. I've basically used my existing DSLR rig that I use for the telephoto lens. I put a couple of wheels on the front of it, and they tilt so it takes up any peculiarities in the ground. And hopefully by lying down behind this, the wildlife won't see me, but we'll see how it goes. Just a quick word on the lens. I usually shoot with a Canon 7D, which has a crop sensor of 1.6. So effectively when you put a lens on that, you get a longer focal length. So this f4 300mm Canon lens becomes a 480mm Canon lens. I use a 1.4 extender, so it comes out to 680mm lens with the loss of one stop, so it's now f5.6. And long lenses are good, but being close to your wildlife is much better. So let's see how it goes now. The Sandspit Reserve is one of my favourite places for the simple reason that I get three different environments right close to each other. There's a long, deserted coastal beach where I see quite a variety of seabirds, as well as the hooded dotteral and pied oyster catchers, and the occasional seal right up at the end. Behind the beach in the sand dunes, there's a dry sandy forest. In this I'll see a great number of parrots, echidnas. I'll see the tracks regularly of Tasmanian devils and quails. On most visits to the forest, I see both species of eagle. There seems to be a family of three white-breasted sea eagles that visit regularly, and also a family of three wedge-tail eagles. And then there's the lagoon, which is fed by the Sandspit Creek. I'll always see black swans, Cape Barren geese, and a variety of ducks on the lagoon. Towards the ocean side, there'll be pied oyster catchers and black oyster catchers, as well as Pacific gulls. And all this seems to happily coexist with the forestry and agriculture that surround it. On these deserted east coast beaches, the hooded dotterals seem to be doing okay. But the problem for them is that we like to be on the beaches at the same time they're nesting. So motorbikes, cars, dogs, etc. have a big impact on them. These images were captured using my trolley wheels on the front of the camera, and it seems to work. The lower aspect really lifts the image. You can see the birds aren't really fussed by my presence. If I was standing, they would be sort of running off the opposite direction. But they seem to be acting quite naturally. So, I think this gadget works. I hope you've enjoyed it. I've certainly had a lot of fun putting it together. I'll be back in about another month with another episode, episode 2, and I hope to see you then. So if you like this, subscribe or click the thumbs up button, and I'll see you next time.